Before you can make a wire model like this, or even this, you're going to need to know some basics about brass tubing, copper wire, and how to solder it all together. Most of the supplies you can get at your local hardware store. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. My sponsor, PCBWay, is having a December 2019 shopping holiday festival sale. They have Xmas coupons for your holiday orders, PCB assembly discounts, and when you share your projects on their site, they have the opportunity to earn gift points that you can use towards future purchases. Check out the link below for more information. All right, here's some basic tools that you're going to need. Some good pliers, needle nose pliers, these are bent ones, and then some clippers so you can cut the wires off. These even have a pair built in, but a special pair of electronic clippers are good. Sandpaper is good for cleaning the oxidation off the copper, a file, and then of course some sort of a soldering iron. Mine's probably a 30 or a 40 watt unit, the more the better. And then that piece of sponge to clean the soldering iron with, and then rosin core solder, which is the key to the whole thing. Two of the other pretty important tools that I use are these jeweler's cross lock tweezers. You can buy these super cheap at a local jewelry store or on Amazon or eBay, but they come in super handy and you'll see me use them very often in this video just to hold the metal because it does get very hot so I don't burn my fingers. All right, let's talk about materials. The majority of what I do, I use brass and copper. The brass I buy from a company called K&S. It comes in packages like this and up to 36 inches long. It even comes in square sizes, and all the pieces telescope so you can put them inside of each other, which comes in very handy, all the way up to thicknesses like this or even square like this. This is the copper that I use. It's about 1 millimeter thick. I've had this for a long time, but most hardware stores will sell packages like this of different thicknesses and gauges. Now, the brass tubing comes straight already. The copper is coiled up on a spool, and we need to make that straight so we can use it, because when it's curved or bent like that, doesn't work so good for modeling, and you can't get any good tension out of the part. So we need to straighten it out, and we're going to use a classic manufacturing technique that they use for straightening all kinds of metals that are extruded, just like this copper, and we're going to anchor it down with a clamp, and the other end, my pliers, I'm just going to pull. Basically, I'm stretching this copper. And stretching it out is going to get me a nice straight piece. And you can do this with just about any kind of copper wire that you buy. It's going to be a little tougher for steel or something like that. But that's the key to making your copper straight so that you can cut it to the size you want and work with it. Let's plug in the soldering iron. Now the copper will usually be oxidized and you will need to sand it nice and smooth so that you can solder it. You need to heat up the copper, and I find that putting a little bit of solder on your soldering iron so that you get a little more surface area to heat up that copper or whatever metal that you're soldering works really well. So I pre-tin the ends, and then this is what you want. You want a butt connection like this, so it's just like a line drawing. This is what you do not want. You do not want the copper overlapping like this so that you get a big fat hairy connection right there. That's not ideal. You want everything to be nice and straight, just like a drawing. So let's make this little hexagon right here, 2 inch. I'm going to sand down my copper first. I'm using a piece of 400 grit sandpaper. I find that this works really well, and I print out a little template for me to follow, and this works really, really well. And then I just use the pliers and I bent it up, and here I'm using a pair of flush cut cutters to cut through both pieces at the same time so I can get a nice clean cut. You get a little bit of a gap there, but we're going to heat up the copper and we're going to fill that in with the rosin core solder. The rosin core has basically the flux built into it, and that allows the solder to flow. So we're going to tin up the corners of this hexagon because we're going to add little legs to connect the two pieces. I'm going to cut some to my desired length, and then I'm going to sand those down to remove the oxidation, and I'm going to tin the ends of all of the little legs so that I can solder them in the corners of the hexagon to make my shape. Let's add the other hexagon to make the other side, and I've actually trimmed them down because I didn't like the proportions of that. And then I'm going to re-tin the ends of each of these legs. Remember, you need to remove the oxidation with some sandpaper to get your solder to stick well. This can be a little tricky right here. That's our first weld where you're putting two pieces together and you're soldering those pieces. Sometimes the wire needs to be readjusted, so it's sort of like erasing and redrawing the line, almost like in digital. So you basically unsolder it and then resolder it the way you want so that you get a good, nice connection. You also see me draw the soldering iron off the connection point, and this is so that I get a nice, smooth solder without getting a big old blob at the connection. So you get a nice smooth part, and here's this finished hexagon part. Let's make a circle with a couple circles, and we'll use some brass for this. So the brass, it's a little thicker, and one way to roll it or curve it is to bend it around a cylindrical object. In this case, I'm bending it around a little paint can. Now, the problem with this method is that you get some spring back, and so you have to basically find the right size tube to bend it around, or you need a little roll bender. This is a guitar fret bending tool, and this allows me to roll the circle in exactly the correct diameter. That is a special tool that I bought on eBay. And then I take the Dremel with a cutoff wheel and I slice through the part that I've bent. Now, the problem with this is that you basically get a gap and you have to bend the circle a little bit more. Let's cut off a little piece of welding rod right here, and this is going to become our stud that goes inside the circle so that we get a nice transition from one end to the other. Yeah, look at that. That way we get a nice, clean, smooth circle. That's sort of the beauty of the brass tubing, is that it's tubing, and you can just get a little piece of metal to get that wonderful transition. Now, this is pretty thick metal. You need to give it a little bit of time to heat up and let the solder flow so that you can solder it together correctly. I'm going to use a file and I'm going to clean up a little bit of that solder just so you get a nice smooth transition visual from one to the other. Let's cut the supporting legs. I'm going to use some brass for this as well. Then I'm going to file the ends to get them nice and smooth. You could drop them onto a belt sander too if you needed. I'm going to tin up the ends here as well. Don't forget to sand them and remove the oxidation from the brass as well. It will oxidize just like the copper will over time. So we'll solder these in with the cross-lock tweezers. Because it's brass, it does take a little bit more heat to heat it up and get it soldered correct. I'm even wearing a pair of gloves here so that I can hold the metal so I don't burn myself. We'll add another set of vertices here. To give it a little bit more strength and stability and give it that 3D look. You get this nice cylinder. Boom. Done. Let's make a cube. We're going to use a slightly different technique for making this cube so we can get some sharper corners. And we're going to cut a V groove into the brass so that we can bend the round tube in a more square shape. This works really nice. You have to, of course, cut a 45 in the end pieces so that you can solder it together and get that nice square. And I'm going to come back and solder each of the corners to give it a little bit of strength and so that we can fill in any gaps as well. And we're going to need that because we're going to solder on some corner posts in the next step. Remember, the brass sucks up the heat from the soldering iron, so you need to heat it up a little bit longer and let that solder flow so that you can get a good connection. I'm using a file here just to sort of clean up a little bit of the solder blobs, and we're going to make another square for the top. In this case, I think I'm using like a 16th inch tubing here. And I'm going to tin up the corners and tin up the legs that are going to connect the top to the bottom as well. It's so much easier if you tin up all the pieces ahead of time before you solder it. It's going to make things so much easier for when you solder two pieces of metal together if they're pre-tinned. So all you have to do is let that solder flow from one piece to the other instead of heating up the entire part because it has that solder on it already. Much, much easier. In this case, there's enough tension on the part where I can just put the brass tube in and it's held in place with the wire model itself. And it just takes a tiny little bit of solder and a little bit of heat to get that to all flow together and be really nice. Again, I'm using a rosin core solder. If your solder does not have a flux, or the rosin core, which has that flux in it, you're gonna have a tough time soldering any metal together. Using that flux to get the solder to flow is absolutely key. I see so many people fail at this point because they are not using any flux with their solder. And I'm going to use a little Dremel wheel here to clean up some of the little solder blobs on this cube just to get it really nice. This is a little bit easier. And you'll get those solder blobs on the end of your soldering iron pretty often. You have to smack them off so that you get just the right amount of solder. So, wire modeling and soldering basics. We're going to use this to build a vehicle in the next video. Hope you enjoyed and you learned something. Go solder something. Have a good time and don't burn yourself. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.